Today we're going to learn the concept of superposition standing waves and standing waves in air columns. Did you ever wonder why we hear high sound and sometimes no sound when we place our ear near the end of a pipe? Well, let's find out the answer in this video. The superposition principle states when two or more waves superpose one another, then the resultant displacement would be the algebraic sum of individual displacements. Standing waves are formed due to the superposition of a forward wave and its reflected wave. In other words, the standing waves are produced when two waves of the same amplitude and frequency, moving in the opposite directions, superpose one another. Standing waves also form in air columns, and the air columns are also called organ pipes. There are two types of organ pipes: open pipes and closed pipes. The standing waves formed in air columns vibrate at resonant frequencies when the frequency of vibrations of air molecules in the pipe matches the frequency of sound. These resonant frequencies in air columns are called harmonics. During the occurrence of harmonics, we hear maximum sound. The nth harmonic frequency of air in the open air column is Fn equals m times v divided by 2l. Here, n is the integer, 1, 2, 3, and so on. V is the speed of sound, and l is the length of air column. The harmonic frequency of air in the closed air column is Fn equals nv divided by 4l. Here, n is the integer, having values 1, 2, 3, 5, and so on. V is the speed of sound, and L is the length of air column. In an open organ pipe, both sides of the pipe are open. On the other hand, the pipe that is closed on one side and open on the other side is known as closed pipe. Let's discuss how the harmonics are observed in an open pipe. At the open end, the displacement of the air particles is maximum and pressure is minimum, which means that at the open end of pipe, antinodes are observed. First harmonic frequency. In this figure, the length of the open organ pipe is L, and as we can see, antinode is formed at the open ends, and exactly at the middle, one node is formed. Recall that the distance between two consecutive nodes or antinodes is equal to half the wavelength, lambda by 2. And the distance between two consecutive node and the antinode is 1/4 of the wavelength, lambda by 4. Thus, the length of the pipe is equal to L is equal to lambda by 4 plus lambda by 4, which is equal to lambda by 2. Thus, lambda is equal to 2L. If the speed of the sound is V, then the first harmonic frequency is F1 is equal to V divided by lambda, which is equal to V divided by 2L. Second harmonic frequency. The length of pipe is equal to L is equal to lambda by 4 plus lambda by 2 plus lambda by 4, which is equal to lambda. The second harmonic frequency is F2 is equal to V divided by lambda, which is equal to V divided by L, which is equal to 2 times V divided by 2L. Similarly, the third, fourth, and nth harmonic frequencies are F3 is equal to 3V divided by 2L, F4 is equal to 4V divided by 2L, and Fn is equal to nV divided by 2L. Now let's learn how the harmonics are observed in the closed pipe. At the closed end, the displacement of the air particles is minimum and pressure is maximum, so nodes are observed at closed end of pipe. First harmonic frequency. Thus, the length of pipe is equal to L is equal to lambda by 4, which implies lambda is equal to 4L. If the speed of the sound is V, then the first harmonic frequency is F1 is equal to V divided by lambda, or F1 is equal to V divided by 4L. The third harmonic frequency. The length of pipe is equal to L is equal to lambda by 2 plus lambda by 4, which is equal to 3 lambda by 4. This implies lambda is equal to 4L divided by 3. The third harmonic frequency is F2 is equal to V divided by lambda, which is equal to V divided by 4L by 3, which is further equal to 3V divided by 4L. Similarly, the fifth and seventh and nth harmonic frequencies are F3 is equal to 5V divided by 4L. F4 is equal to 7V divided by 4L. Fn is equal to nV divided by 4L. In this video, we have learnt the superposition of waves and formatting of stationary waves in air columns, and we have also understood why sometimes we hear the maximum sound.